Jeff Dodds for Virgin Media, and I'm the Chief Operating Officer here. So I look after our consumer business effectively. So sales, marketing, commercial, strategy, customer service, the whole operations side of the business. If you think about a football coach or a rugby coach or a netball coach, whoever, they're working with a small group of people, and that gives them the ability to be really clear on the purpose of the team, to be really clear on the tactics, and then during the match, to give really clear feedback, play people in position, play to their strengths, having the ability to work on tactics in the moment, so to trade hard, to change direction, be more flexible, be more agile. I think that style probably lends itself more effectively to working with a small business. Leading teams during really challenging times, of course, is the true test of leadership. If you're in a sailboat with your team and the sun's shining and it's dead calm and you're drinking champagne, it's easy to be a brilliant leader and it's easy to be part of a brilliant team when that's the environment. Then when you get gale force winds and you're fighting the wind and you're trying to put up sails and you're all leaning out the boat, that's when true leaders and true teams have to perform at their best, focusing on the few things that make the biggest difference. Communication, talking more about what you're trying to achieve, how you're performing in the moment, being crystal clear on your objectives and your tactics, and just dialing up the basics of leadership. I think there are negative connotations to the word compromise. I think modern terms for it would be you're more flexible or you're agile, you can change direction quickly, you can make choices in the moment. That's not a bad thing. You need to have that skill to be an effective leader. Somebody could buy a product from us online. It could be delivered and they could install it themselves. And if there's a problem and an engineer goes out and they ring the doorbell, that could be the only physical face-to-face interaction that person ever has with somebody from Virgin. So it isn't about wandering in and fixing a router or fixing a TV box. It's about going in and representing the brand and the 50-odd years of heritage that comes with that brand. So for me, it starts with employees. And happy employees breed happy customers. Each to their own, but about 10 years ago, I started mindfulness, the ability to try and bring yourself back to the present, so to center yourself, to stop worrying about things that have already happened, that you can't impact, to not try to think too much about what might happen in the future and create anxiety around that, but instead to bring yourself back to what can I actually do today that will make a difference. And I think for me, that's been incredibly helpful because it's cleared my brain from a lot of noise and helped me to really focus in on the things that we can do in the moment to have the biggest impact for the business. I hear a lot of people talk about work-life balance, and sadly for me, I think that's a complete misnomer, because the reality is the two things are part of the same. They're part of me, they're part of my whole. I go to work during the day, I come home, I might still be thinking about work. When I'm work, I'm dealing with personal things occasionally. So it's not about the two things balancing each other out, it's about finding harmony between work and your personal life. To run an effective business, you need largely a balance of great thinking, great doing, and great connecting. And I talk about that as strategic thinking, operational delivery, and network skills, and the ability to connect the community across the organization to deliver something effectively. And everybody I've ever worked with fits somewhere in that triangle. Be really comfortable where you are. Find out where you add your most value to the organization and just be brilliant at it. Don't obsess about trying to be somebody you aren't, because every great organization needs people in every bit of that triangle.